Hello everybody, in this video we discuss about the reaction of haloalkane with aqueous potassium hydroxide or aqueous alkali and reaction of haloalkane with alcoholic potassium hydroxide or alcoholic alkali, alcoholic solution of alkali. So watch this video, you can understand the difference between the aqueous potassium hydroxide and alcoholic potassium hydroxide or aqueous alkali and alcoholic alkali reaction with alkyl halide. So this one is the first case when aqueous potassium hydroxide reacts with haloalkane, it's form alcohol plus KX. So this one is a nucleophilic substitution reaction because here X is substituted by OH, so it's a nucleophilic substitution reaction. Nucleophilic substitution occur in the case where haloalkane reacts with aqueous potassium hydroxide, but in the second case when alkyl halide reacts with alcoholic potassium hydroxide, that time alkene forms. Here is an example, ethyl bromide when reacts with potassium hydroxide alcoholic, it gives ethene as alkene. So alkyl halide on reaction with alcoholic potassium hydroxide, a substitution reaction takes place. This is substitution reaction takes place here when alkyl halide reacts with alcoholic potassium hydroxide. It is addition reaction. So we have to understand both the cases. Ethyl bromide when reacts with potassium hydroxide alcoholic, it produces ethene, it's an elimination reaction. Okay, and this one for the case of ethyl bromide reaction with aqueous, its replacement occur bromine, so this is a substitution reaction. Substitution reaction occur when aqueous potassium hydroxide reacts with ethyl bromide, a substitution reaction occur, nucleophilic substitution reaction, but when alcoholic potassium hydroxide reacts with ethyl bromide, it gives an elimination reaction. So here the difference is due to the polarity of the solvent. Here the solvent is alcohol, here the solvent is water aqueous, and here the solvent is alcohol. So actually in the polarity, water have higher polarity than alcohol. So due to higher polarity prefers substitution, and the lower polarity prefers elimination reaction. And for this reason, in the second case when ethyl bromide reacts with alcoholic potassium hydroxide, an elimination reaction occur because here alcohol is less polar or low polarity. Solvent polarity when low, that bring about elimination, and when the solvent polarity is high, that time it favors substitution reaction, like in this case. Okay, so these two are the general equation when alkyl halide reacts with aqueous potassium hydroxide and alcoholic potassium hydroxide. So these are the differences between the potassium hydroxide reaction as aqueous potassium hydroxide and alcoholic potassium hydroxide with haloalkane. So this is the discussion about this topic. That's it. I think you understand this topic well.